not much of a fall up here. It goes right from summer to winter. The other day it was sweating. Today, we're freezing. Got the RV in the backyard. It's where it'll sit. So we got first gear, but had to rev it about 80,000 RPMs to get it to back up. So we're into October and it's time. See if we can make a little cash today. We got all the just a little air in the tires, you know. But we got all the good stuff. All the ACs have broken down. We got bus radiators, all sorts of good stuff. Stainless steel. We got aluminum. That's a very impressive heavy barrel of number one copper. All the cords, cut them all off. All the cords I get, all the wire goes into one bucket. All the compressors from the ACs. Some guys go one step further, cut them open to get the copper out, but I just scrap them just like that. All this stuff is just all, when I do my regular scrap pickups, it's all the extras. I just kind of put aside and throw in the barrel. It's all the number two copper, see? All that solder, all those connections, and that weird coating on that, but that's all number two. A little less money. Got a whole bunch of brass. What's that baby hiding down there? Bucket of brass. He's warming up. Squatting pretty good. A little air in the tires. Canadian Thanksgiving. See if we can make a little money, have a decent day here. Heard a really loud bang in the back. He's sitting a little funny. A lot lower than it was.
Well, that'll do it. Snapped it right off.
Keep going. Yep, so the old leaf spring shackle let go. Spring popped right up into the bed. So that's what the loud noise was. I could actually feel it inside the truck. So that's pretty good. We've moved on to the back roads. Probably the smartest idea. Looks a little wonky with all the weight. So I don't want to attract the attention of any state police. So it adds about 20 minutes onto our trip, but it does seem to surprisingly roll pretty good still, so just chug along. And we'll just go about our day. Not gonna be a fun job to do that shackle. Probably gonna need torches to get that out of there. But it's for another day. Ooh, yeah. As you can see, some of the big hitters. That number one copper. Copper aluminum radiators. All those ACs. Nice little bucket of brass. Adds up quick. Even that number two. Small bucket of that. Kind of hard to believe. That was worth 54. And then that number one was 100. There you go. Cut my head. A piece of aluminum got me. Worth it. Just shy of $500. Not a bad day. Keep in mind, all that stuff was free. It's all saved up, you know, throughout the summer. Pretty much every time I go pick up a bunch of metal from somebody, there's always something a little extra. Could be a tiny little piece of brass, it could be some copper pipes. All the cords on the appliances I cut off, throw them in a bucket. Just usually the aluminum, I have been saving that. I used to not do aluminum because I just need it. It's just so light, it takes a lot to make something, you know. It's all just free stuff saved up. And, makes for one nice little payday at the end of the season, I guess. Of course, I'll still get more stuff throughout the winter, but not as much as summertime. Price of steel is, light iron is 2 cents a pound. So, hardly worth doing it. I gotta drive, burn about 20 bucks of gas, fill my truck up, like, $30, so it's not much profit there, but I provide a service for a lot of people. Sometimes I'll even have some trash to go to the dump or something, and they'll pay me a little, you know, a few bucks to do that if they don't have a truck or, you know, something to get it there with. But lately, for the appliances and, you know, general light iron, I've had to, I've started charging people. And it's working out so far. They don't mind paying a few bucks, at least to cover my gas. It's all I really ask for. One problem is the fridges. Anything with Freon, fridges, freezers. Of course, the ACs I strip anyway, but this place here that I go to now, they don't take any of that stuff. They don't take fridges or nothing. They must not have the license for the Freon. So what I do is I gotta charge the people, because at the town dump they charge about $10 per fridge or freezer. So yeah, I gotta pay the $10, so I gotta charge the people that, and then charge them a little bit to, you know, to take it, depending on how far away it is. So I've been doing that. It's working out. I mean, the people don't have a truck, they don't have nothing. You know, no way of getting that fridge even to the dump, so it's worth it to them. Toss me a couple bucks, and that's it. Just keep on going. I tell you, the truck ride's pretty good with broken shackles. But getting on the interstate now, I'm gonna head back. I think I'll be eating something good tonight. Celebrate. That's what I'm talking about. Spicy. Not really. Supposed to have some mighty hot sauce. Comes with these. Girl's like, we haven't had that 2 weeks. Oh. I apologize. How about the buffalo sauce then? Same thing, no? No.